So if you operate your business, whereas this is the order of priority of the actions that you take, then you're gonna succeed at a very high level. Whereas in the morning from 9 to 12, if you don't have one of those four things happening, then we're making calls. I get Zillow leads, cool, we gotta call them. You better be getting enough to stay on the phone between 9 and 12. We're gonna make calls. If we have to show property that morning, great. Don't beat yourself up that you didn't get to make the calls, because showing property is more important than the calls. It's okay. Get right back on your calls tomorrow. You see how this works? If you have one of those four things happening, it's okay to skip the calls or anything else. But the problem is people are putting stuff in that number three category, which is everything else. They're putting that above the calls. That's where the problem is. Even though that has happened, inventory hasn't opened up. See, a lot of these sellers are still in the same boat, even though the market softened, they're still in the same boat of not being able to find something to move to because inventory hasn't, you know, skyrocketed. So they're still in the same boat. That's why the market has softened, but we aren't seeing, you know, sellers calling us to list their properties, because until we, it's gonna kind of be a chicken and egg thing, which is gonna come first. You know, without the seller saying, hey, I wanna sell, you know, inventory can't really go up. And then, but because inventory doesn't go up, they're not really want to sell. So it's one of those tug and pull things. All right. So, but I think at some point something's going to happen and something's got to give, and in my opinion. But listen, here's the cool thing. When you're out there and you're building and you're accumulating, it doesn't matter what the market does. Nobody can predict what the market's going to do. Stop trying to predict the market, even in your own head. That's number one. Number two, even if the market goes down, how are you supposed to know that? You know what I mean? This is their decision. They're adults. Okay, they can make their own decisions and stuff. Your job is to help them do what they want to do, not what you want them to do or what you think they should do. You're trying to service your clients. Don't start playing this God of real estate game where you tell us what the prices are going to be in 5 years, because I promise you, bro, you have no earthly clue what prices are going to be in 5 years. The best way to prepare for whatever the market's going to do is to have the largest database going in.
If you're about to have to quit the business and go back to your 9 to 5. There you go, guys. We just reduced the failure rate by 5 people. Let me tell you something. When you stop doing what you're doing for money, I don't care if it's real estate, I don't care what business it is, I don't care if it's insurance, car sales, any business. When you stop doing what you're doing for money and you start doing it just to help people, two things happen. I promise you, two things happen. One, you get really happy. And two, you get really wealthy.